been sleeping here instead. I've been sleeping in my bed. Sleeping in my bed. So show me, family, all the blood that I will bleed. I don't know where I belong. I don't know where I went wrong. But I can write a song. I belong to you. You belong to me, my sweetheart. I belong to you. You belong to me, my sweetheart.
George said, first and foremost, keep God in the center of your life and your marriage. Number two, love each other, honor each other, and obey each other all the days of your life. And number three, don't ever go to sleep mad or angry with one another. Okay? Your grandmother learned this one way early on in our marriage, and I never, ever regretted it because I lost a lot of sleep. Okay? She never made me go to sleep unless we resolved our issues. So you don't want to be angry. And after all these years, I find out it's biblical. Check it out. Ephesians 4:26. Don't go to sleep angry with one another because anger is a foothold for the devil. So keep those three thoughts in your mind, you'll be great.
I'd like to thank everyone for coming out for Johnny and Hannah to celebrate this special day. And I'm very happy for you both. And I like to think that Johnny B is my cousin, more like my brother instead of my cousin. Brother that he never had. And I like to try and do this speech without any note cards or anything down, because I've had some experience with this guy over here. I could talk about Johnny B all day, but I'm gonna ask Hannah a question real quick. What last name are you gonna take? Charlie Brown or Burke?
Brown?
Yeah. Well, I could sit here and talk about Johnny B, Charlie Brown all day, but I'll tell you one story. I remember the first time me and Johnny went hunting together. We were in San Diego, and Aunt Fran finally let him come with us. Finally let him come with us to the friggin' San Diego. So I wanted to show him everything. And so I took him all the way to the top of the mountain. We hung out, looked for some deer, and we didn't see nothing. So we ate lunch, hung out, and finally it was time to come down. And it was time to come down. We were like, I was 14. He was probably like 10 years old. So we started coming down, and I'm like ahead of him, leading the way. And all of a sudden, I'm like 10 feet ahead of him. I take a break, and then Johnny hits me in the back. I look around, and he's laying on the floor because he got laid down. He's like, Charlie, I don't know how to stop. I'm thinking, oh, dang. My friend's gonna kill me if he gets hurt. So I was like, all right, you take my lead. I'll go down 10 feet, and then I'll tell you when to come down. So then I started going down the mountain. I looked up, and I said, John, time to come down. Come on. He says, all right. And here he comes in full stride. He couldn't stop, so I sat there, I braced myself, and I caught him. I was like, all right, we'll do this the whole way down. So we did that the whole way down, laughing. We didn't see nothing. And then all of a sudden, yeah, we scared all the deer away. So finally, we get down to the bottom, and that was it. But the whole end of the story. That was it. He was hooked after that. He was hooked after that one. But the moral of the story is, I'll always be here for you, John.
You give me hope every day of my life, and you always encourage me to be a better person. And I thank you every day for that. And Johnny, thank you for keeping her at your house. No get back. Keep her.
Thank you.